Hello everyone and welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. On today's feature, we're going to be diving into Dropbox Paper. I wanted to show you around the application that is developed by Dropbox, give a little bit of the information, and hopefully help you to make a decision on this application. Now, as you can imagine, we'll be reviewing this on the web version. There is an iOS application and an Android application in which you can access Dropbox Paper, and it now is about 3 years old, so it's relatively stable in the market as a way for you to create notes, documents, mood boards, whatever it is. We'll be showcasing two examples in this feature. We're going to be creating some meeting notes and also followed by a project of some kind. We're going to create a miniature document for a project. Now, some of the key bits of information, this is a little bit like a Google document to some extent. You can go ahead and create a new document and it's in the same familiar format. However, you get some more interactive elements that are better for projects. And I also believe that it's better for collaboration as well. It just feels more interactive. And also you get a lot more sort of features that are related to collaboration. And it will connect up your Dropbox account. So this is obviously connected to how much storage you have on there. And you can also insert pre-created files and folders that you already have. There are a bunch of templates, but we'll come to them at the end. Let's jump into Dropbox Paper. So guys, just before we dive in, I just want to let you know you can subscribe to Keep Productive. We put regular videos about all range of tools. So it'd be great to have you as a follower. So here we are. We're on paper.dropbox.com. And as you can see, I have used it in the past with some clients in terms of being able to, for example, I used it with Diana when we were sort of mood boarding a few designs. And this is a sort of general layout of Dropbox Paper in terms of you can embed videos, you can embed images. And the nice thing is you can communicate on there with other people in terms of adding GIFs. And as you can see, you can even add interactive elements in which we'll come to. Now, to start, I wanted to showcase the meeting agenda abilities because I think the meeting notes are really interactive as a way to be able to take general meeting notes. It could be on a specific event or on a specific project you're working on. Then we'll dive into the project details. So inside of Paper, you get you can see all of your documents here. And it, obviously you can check the ones that have been starred. So you can simply star one of them just by unstarring them or starring the document. You can select multiple ones of them, even move them, export them, archive them, delete them, which makes it really easy to navigate your account. You can access your folders here. So if you've got a specific folder with docs in, and you can manage all the general documents here, and you can even sort them based on who's owning them, what they're shared with. Which makes it really accessible. So you normally land on this page and up here you can connect with your Google Calendar. So up here you can see that a Google Calendar option, it pulls in whatever's in your Google Calendar and that's one of the selections when you go to get started with your Paper account, whatever you've got on your calendar. Now this is a meeting with Marie Pullison who is gonna be touring us around her Notion account. I was really a Wally and misjudged the time. So this is not actually the meeting, but in this case, I'm just gonna go ahead and create a meeting agenda. So once you click on it, it will obviously bring you to this pre-created page. So the great thing is once you connect it with a calendar event, and you can connect it to, for example, you want to link it to another calendar event. So two calendar events you can do, and it brings in whatever's on your calendar. In this case, I don't need meeting agendas for a pool and a pint, but you get the idea. You're able to connect to whatever's existing on your calendar. So it will create this sort of meeting notes layout for you with the date, the attendees, and the agenda, discussion, action to items. So it's a pre-created template, which makes it really interactive. So one of the things you can do is, for example, you can say, okay, this is me in here. So that's just at doc. And you can also tag other people that might already be in your Dropbox. They'll automatically get invites to the document when they're tagged, which is really helpful. So that's one of the bonuses. And you can start listing what's in the agenda. So for example, we could say catch up about Notion and then do Notion tour. And I could even add like 20 mins. So there we go. You can start adding an agenda. You can actually talk about what was discussed. And then also the actions. So what's good about the actions is they're this sort of checkbox, and the checkbox can be created down here. So if you want to create more, you can do. So what you can do here is actually just type in what was needed to get done, and you can tag certain people, but you can tag them and set a due date over here. So for example, if I wanted to be like, okay, I'm going to tag myself and set a due date of the 31st. So you can say like edit feature. Then I'm going to get that as a task. And you're probably wondering, where the heck is this going to be located? Because obviously you're going to have multiple of these as you go across and adding more and more. So if I go out of this, you can obviously see meeting notes have been created and they've been added to this, and they're actually logged as unfiled already. But you can see the task go up here. So you can see edit the feature. So you can see it by document or by date. So for example, due tomorrow. So it's almost like a mini task manager there, which is quite handy. Now going back into this, if I wanted to, I could add it to a specific folder like sample docs, and it automatically adds that. I can go up here and I can invite certain people to it, which is really easy to do so. I can go ahead and publish the document if I wanted to, which means that it will allow other people to see it and make comments. You can add a link to it. So if you want to share it, present it, which is really, really attractive actually, in terms of being able to view it on screen. You can even change it to dark mode if you wanted to. If you're having that special meeting in the evening, that might be helpful. Maybe it's less stressful for people's eyes as well. You can also star it, follow it, which helps you to keep updated with other stuff. And there are a bunch of sharing settings as well. Now, in terms of traditional document experiences, you get the doc history, you get the word count, which gives you information about how many words and characters has been used. Now, you can also see the comment history and the changes that have been made to the document, and you can also roll back to that version, very similar to Google Documents. Now, one of the things you can do is actually templatize this. So, for example, if you wanted and you created your own template that you're pretty impressed with or you're happy with as a new document, you can go ahead and add that to your template gallery, which means in future you can replicate it. So it's essentially a faster way of duplication. You can present, print, and export. The exportabilities are fairly easy. You can export as Microsoft Doc, Markdown, or even publish the document, which gives all of, but it hides all that. It says here, share a version that hides comments, names, and doc history. Anyone with a link can have access. So that might be good for external people. Now inside of here, you can also search your paper for any upcoming meetings. It breaks down quite nicely and gives you a preview. I actually didn't know that they gave you a preview, which makes it really attractive. You can't scroll through the preview, but that's really nice. You can set a keyword or a certain person that you may be working with. You can check all of your notifications here, which gives you indications of, for example, who's commented on something, and you can add all the, obviously mark them as read or unread. Now up in the top right-hand corner, you can just go ahead and create a new document pretty easily if you're looking to sort of stay within this window. But if you want to come out of this, you can see that as you see now, a task appears inside of here. So it automatically detects a task based on who it's been assigned to, which is very, very handy. Now, if I wanted to, I could share this quite fast without needing to necessarily go into the document. Well, obviously it opens it up as a document, but that makes it really easy to get started with. And you get a little icon as well, depending on the certain project that is, it's obviously being created. So for example, in this case, meeting notes gives this lovely like alarm clock style thing. So I could go ahead and create a new document. And maybe this is a good opportunity to show you some of the features that are involved inside of a document. So obviously you've got your traditional multimedia ones like images, media, which can be videos and things like that. But you can also insert existing Dropbox links that you may have, or even stuff in your files. So maybe I wanted to add this whole module so that people can have a link out to, and you can see here that it actually gives you a preview. There's actually was nothing in there, but it gives you a preview of what was inside that Dropbox area, and you can go ahead and delete that quite easily. Now if you want to, you can create a traditional table, and I would just refer this very similar to Evernote to some extent, because it's a very basic table, so it's not really going to break the bank or just make it a fantastic table experience. But it's a good start. But the real magic is in timeline abilities, and this is really helpful for projects. So we'll show you how this can be used in projects, but it allows you to see, for example, a month view and begin planning You can assign tasks to people. And again, this appears inside of the tasks or to-dos area that you can see up here. And the great thing with this is if, for example, if you want to go to a to-do that you've got, it will automatically take you there, which is really, really helpful. Okay, guys, so they used to have a specific templates area. It actually just seems to be not there, but I'll include the link if there is one. But you used to be able to create templates. For example, this one was a project plan, and you could basically add the name of the project. And this is pre-built, which is really helpful. So you can obviously get started with it. So for example, there's a goal section, what you're trying to accomplish, a table that indicates some of the tasks and some of the associated ownerships of those tasks, due dates, and also the deliverables. So that's just a very simple table. So obviously that's a good way in getting started. You could create your own one of these, if I'm honest. It would be pretty easy to do so. So let's go ahead and create that. It might actually help you to understand the sort of features of this experience. So let's go ahead and call it project plan. I'm going to go ahead and add goal as one of the top projects, and I'm going to just change the highlight on that one. That's going to be a bold one. Then we're going to add the to-dos. So we're just going to create these ones as heading ones because they're nice and clear. So we might in this case actually just start adding to-dos here, and just below it we're going to add this new timeline ability so I can see the full month. And what I can start doing here is just adding tasks. So for example, in this case, I might want to say, research titles, and maybe want to add descriptions, choose the title options for new book. So there we go. I've obviously added something to get me started. I can move the length of this one, which is really easy to do so, or even just drag a few more on if I wanted to. And obviously it's very easy because once you've got more people, you can start adding and obviously assigning it to other people. So it's really easy for other people to add more details. Now, one of the things you can do is you can add milestones as well, which is really easy. And that helps you to determine when you need to be doing certain things by. On the 9th, I could say choose titles. And that would be a way for me to see the indication of that. And I can just change the relativity. So for example, if I want to see it in 2 weeks or a quarter, then I get a bit of an idea of how close I am to those goals. Now, the nice thing is you've obviously got this really smooth way of viewing the quarters if you wanted to. And if you had quite a large document, you could obviously scan through using the outline on the left-hand side. So guys, Dropbox Paper is a really fun, interactive way to create documents. Now, it is backed by Dropbox, which always helps. There doesn't seem to be any limits to the storage right now. It's available on iOS and Android and also has a web version. Right now, it doesn't have a Mac version, which is a bit of a shame, but it's a good application if you're looking to take meeting notes, create simple project plans, and coordinate that with other people, whether they have Dropbox or not. Very similar to Google Drive, as I said, but also an opportunity for you to go a bit more interactive with timelines and tables. Anyway, guys, a big thank you for stopping by. Hopefully this was helpful, and make sure to subscribe to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. See you guys later.